And we're joined on the phone today by the one and only Dee Snider of Twisted Sister. Dee, how you doing?
I am doing as well as one can be expected to do in the world we live in now.
Well, it's an honor to be speaking with you. I appreciate you taking the time with me today.
I'm glad to. Thanks.
Well, first of all, it's great to hear your daughter back in the States here after being stranded outside of the country. As you mentioned, definitely a scary time here.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm trying to bring attention to the other realities that people don't see. You know, it's very easy when you hear about people who were stuck out of the country, you know, and then the president gave them you got 72 hours to get back here. We're closing our borders. On paper, it sounds all well and good. But this is the vacation time, the high season. And millions of people around the world are on vacations. It's spring break. So when this went down, so many people were away from home. And when the announcement started to come that they were closing borders, everybody was desperately trying to get home, trying to get a flight. And that was insane in and of itself. I remember being on hold for 4 hours trying to book my daughter a flight back. But then countries like Peru just closed their borders without warning and refused to allow anybody in or out, and pretty much holding foreign nationals hostage. I've been doing it now for weeks, and that's one of the things. My daughter's out, but I've been trying to tell people. I told the people on social media that I'd continue to get the word out and just make people aware that it's not that simple, and there are still people who are stranded far from home.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of uncertainty in the world these days, and you know, just the average person maybe doesn't even have the means or the funds to just book random flights to get people back home.
Well, you know, credit to our government and the efforts they're making. Ultimately, they were the ones who got a charter flight to take my daughter, and they've been bringing people home from all over the world, thousands and thousands of people who are stranded, and on their dime, quite honestly, which is amazing. But just to give you kind of perspective, England, I saw in an article yesterday, spending £75 million to bring back over 200,000 citizens who were stranded overseas. So this was a time where every country is dealing with the problem. But Peru is unique in that they decided to play chess with our tourists who were there and do what we say, well, we want you to bring our people back, and then we'll let you bring your people back. So this has been an ongoing issue.
Well, I know you've always got multiple projects going on. How has this affected you? Have you been able to keep working for the most part?
For the 2 weeks that she was there, and, you know, she got there on the 12th, the gates, so to speak, shut down in Peru on the 15th. She got back last Thursday. I couldn't even think straight. I mean, my focus, and I just went full Liam Neeson. And this is something I'm here to tell people. If you have a stranded family member, it's not just, call the embassy, call your representatives. You got to do that. But you got to pull out all the stops. You never know who might be able to help you get your family member home. And we were looking at every aspect. I was talking to Black Ops, mercenaries, all kinds of military organizations, anything and everything. There were people in the jungle working their way to where my daughter was for an extraction in the event that the government was unable to get her back. But thankfully, we didn't have to resort to that because that would have been an ugly way to be brought home.
Yeah, it's great. It all worked out. And, you know, as you mentioned, you're out there spreading the word. I know you've got a great platform with the House of Hair. I wanted to ask you about that. I've been listening a long time. I didn't realize you were approaching, 25 years almost of that show.
Yeah, it's crazy. You know, I remember starting the show and saying to my producer, Pam Edwards, who is the creator of the show, I said, so what do you think? We got like, what, 3-5 years on this thing? And she said, are you kidding me? This is a soundtrack to people's lives. As long as they're alive, they're going to want to hear that soundtrack. And here we are, it's, like coming up to a quarter of a century, over 220 stations in North America, and now we're in other countries around the world, and the show shows no sign of stopping. So I guess as long as I'm standing up, I'm above ground and able to rant and rave, we're going to be rocking.
Well, you've done, music, radio, acting, theater? I mean, is there something else out there you haven't tried that you'd like to?
Well, you know, like I said, until I got my daughter home, I couldn't think straight. But I was supposed to be directing my first feature film, a movie I wrote called My Enemy's Enemy. But all film productions have gone on hiatus right now, and TV productions, everything's at a standstill. I'm writing my first fictional novel. I'm just about finished with that. So that I'm back to working on. I'm going to finish that up. And I actually have a live Blu-ray, a live concert video, and an album coming out this summer, which may be timely since all the live shows are being canceled. So people can pretend they're at the concert in their living room and rock out to Dee Snider from my world tour last year.
Excellent. Yeah, definitely looking forward to that. And I don't know if I'll ever get a chance to speak with you again, so I got to ask your memories of appearing in Pee-wee's Big Adventure. That was the first time I was turned on to you guys.
It's so fun. That's a starting point for so many people. It was really odd. You know, I had met Pee-wee at a New Year's Eve party, and before he became like a child star, or whatever you want to call it, he was like just a comedian, a really weird, quirky comedian doing the college circuit, club circuit. And I was a big fan of his. He was a fan of mine. So when he was filming his first movie, he said, "Hey, man, will you do a cameo?" And I was like, "Yeah, absolutely." You know, we didn't know what it was. And I remember going down to the set, and it gave me the bug to write movies and be more involved in producing and acting. And it was Tim Burton's first feature film. I remember going, and he was dressed like Pee-wee. I go, "Hey, who's that dude?" He goes, "Oh, that's Tim. He's directing the movie." I'm like, "Hey, man, what's up?" And so, you know, from that movie, that was a starting point for a crazy career for Pee-wee and for Tim.
Awesome. I'm a huge fan, Dee, and it's great that your daughter's back and you're doing so well, and I'm honored to be speaking with you again. Thank you so much.
Thanks, brother. I appreciate it. Thank you.
And again, that was the one and only Dee Snider of Twisted Sister here on the Five Count.